Whether you're a bodybuilder or strength athlete, pressing with dumbbells is one of the best things to do for your gains. In today's video, I'll be covering the top 3 benefits in full detail, starting with the bench press specifically. Even though I love the barbell version and credit to most of my chest gains, I would have to say that the dumbbell version may just be slightly better for chest hypertrophy. And it's not because of range of motion, more on that later. It has to do with the main function of the pecs. If I told you right now to have your arms out to the side and flex as hard as you can, what would you do? This motion right here. Which makes sense. The pecs pull on the humerus, upper arm bone, to the midline of the body. Horizontal adduction. And a barbell bench press has you pressing in a fixed position. It's up and down, causing you to lose around 15% of the range of motion, which may not be a huge deal in the grand scheme of things, especially since we can lift heavier. And obviously, total volume counteracts a lot of these things, as well as higher exercise selection. But on an exercise per exercise basis, or what emphasizes the chest the most, the dumbbell version has that slight advantage on paper. So we're talking about degrees of contraction and the form being vastly different. On a dumbbell bench press, you are always going to be moving inwards. Going to the side is not happening when heavy weights are used. Yet the barbell bench press coaches this exactly. This is pretty much what every top strength coach recommends. Pull the bar apart, break the bar, spread it, never inwards. You can try to cue that if you want to for better chest activation, but there's a difference between mind-muscle connection and what's actually occurring biomechanically. Now to me, that explains perfectly why we tend to see higher triceps activation in the barbell bench press compared to its dumbbell counterpart. So let's make it clear that it's the humeral adduction that's giving you the better pec gains, not the deeper range of motion, because there are some huge flaws to that line of thinking, which I've talked about so much in the past. As the size of dumbbells increase, you are reducing range of motion. So even if you touch your chest, it's no longer the same as when you're using those 50-pound dumbbells. Yet despite this partial feature, many lifters still swear by this for pec gains, and it's one of the main assistance movements in many bench press programs. That said, if you still want to talk about the range of motion part, okay, there is a way around this, by doing higher reps. If you stick to the 15 to 20 zone, most of you will probably not do that with 100-pound dumbbells. You're going to be on the lighter end, and therefore, the size will be closer to what you're used to using. And in that case, yeah, you're getting a bit more range of motion compared to the barbell version. But after a certain point, let me say that this becomes less feasible. Like when I was doing my 405 bench, I can't tell you what I'd be able to dumbbell bench because I wasn't doing them at the time, but I'd sure as hell be maxing out the dumbbell stack at a local gym. And in that case, the size would be an issue, and it's no different for me doing any bench press with a bar. So this is great depending on your experience level. Like I said, most of you are probably gonna be fine. And also you can bring the dumbbells further out, but then you're kind of combining it with a chest fly at the same time. So there's nothing wrong with that for pec gains, but don't call it a normal dumbbell bench press. Your body wants to stay more in for a reason. So the neutral grip is best for this, or you can bring the dumbbells higher up on the chest and flare a little bit more. But if you notice shoulder discomfort, I'd recommend just doing it the regular way, and that partial will be more worth it for your longevity. So we don't wanna try to use the maximum range of motion every single time if it's messing with our body leverages. So that's the first and most important benefit. The second is the fact that dumbbells act as specialty barbell replacements. For those who don't go to hardcore gyms, or maybe you wanna do some neutral grip presses like my Swiss bar right there. It's one of the main ways I got so strong on the bench. Guess what? You can do that with dumbbells because the hand motion can be freely manipulated. There is zero restriction, whereas the barbell, what can you do? Close grip bench, regular grip, wide, illegally wide, reverse grip as well. And then if you have a Swiss bar, you can use the full-on neutral, you can do the semi-neutral this way, or the other way around. But you're locked into that range of motion throughout the entire set, and if you want to change up the grip, well, you have to have a barbell that allows for that. Whereas the dumbbells naturally offer more variations by themselves, which is also great for minimizing overuse or working through potential nagging pains. Like if your shoulders aren't feeling the best and you don't wanna go do a 3 sets of 10 flat bench with 225 right after your first press, maybe say an incline barbell, now you can do the dumbbell edition. Bring those arms more in. It doesn't have to be all the way neutral. It could be in between, and you're good to go. You're not gonna get injured. So depending how you feel that day, these can act as an auto-regulation tool and completely replace what you would do on a more expensive, space-taken barbell. For example, if you're using Olympic dumbbells, you can stack a bunch of 25s instead of 10s. This way, we're doing more of a board press instead of manually having to do partials. Hey, if you've been doing nothing but incline barbell presses and exhausted all the variations, instead of swapping that out for a different angle like flat or decline, you can just do an incline dumbbell bench. Then a few weeks after that, you can start pausing on it. Then you could do the neutral style. So this allows you to extend the specificity of your program through the assistance movements. And that is a massive benefit for any serious lifter. Whether using the conjugate system, a more minimalist setup, or just a basic bodybuilding program, you don't need all these specialty barbells if you have access to simple dumbbells, because in that, we have all the variety we'll pretty much need, which is absolutely fucking insane. And there's a reason why they're always sold out online. It's because of the flexibility they offer. Finally, we got to talk about muscular imbalances, but not in the traditional sense, because you've been told that if you switch to a dumbbell bench press, that's automatically going to solve you from pressing unevenly like this. When in reality, this issue is typically caused by pre-existing muscular imbalances that are usually in the back, by the way, not actually your pressing muscles. It's the fact that you're a little bit wider on one side and not as tight, as well as teaching yourself improper form on the barbell version. So if you did nothing but barbell presses and rotated through many variations to develop your general strength while attacking the weak muscles that are breaking down that lift, you wouldn't have an issue. But that doesn't take away from the fact that we can still use dumbbells to correct imbalances. So I don't want to confuse you, but let me just say this simply. If you train each arm independently as opposed to both at the same time, now you got a real solution. And this applies to every muscle group. I'm going to talk about the presses specifically. If whenever you barbell bench press, your right arm comes up faster than your left, start doing dumbbell bench presses with the left arm first. And you can grab onto the power rack or even the side for support. But I recommend something secure. Get those reps in. This allows you to maximally focus on the weaker side, and you can clearly see what that number imbalance is. Whereas the regular version, both arms will stop at the same time, but you didn't know what your potential was on the stronger side. And when you start training each arm independently, you'll figure that out real fast. Like, trust me, within one workout, you'll know if there's an imbalance. You might get 7 reps on your left arm, 10 on your right. Guess what? That's not normal. Sure, we're asymmetrical beings. We're not going to be one-to-one, but it should be as close as possible to it after a certain point. And that's why when we look at studies at the bilateral deficit, it diminishes with training experience, which is to be expected. So if you're a seriously strong bencher, yet there's like 5 reps difference between each arm, man, that's probably one of the main reasons why you may be having plateaus right now. So it's important to at least test. Train each arm one at a time. See if there's a strength imbalance on the pressing part itself, because now you can lock yourself in on the back, even if there is an imbalance on that part and what you cued yourself to do form-wise on the bilateral stuff. So with this, with that intent, if you still can't reproduce the same numbers, there's a problem. And at least now, we can literally train that one side exclusively, or at least do more volume and more intensity for that overall. Like in my case, I developed a real muscular imbalance in my lats from doing more work on the left side of one arm pull-ups compared to the right. So I know that it's 100% possible to create imbalances by overloading an area more. And therefore, we can apply that same logic to dumbbell pressing. In fact, a really cool recommendation I heard years ago was to do a Bulgarian light training cycle for the weaker side. So imagine going 1 to 4 weeks of doing nothing but one side of pressing, which you would think would cause the other side to get that much weaker, but that's not what we see. In fact, it tends to be a neurological component that still gives you carryover in some way, which is weird, but that's what the research seems to indicate. So if you tear your left bicep and only train your right arm, Once that left bicep is fully recovered, you'll find that you lost less strength than if you didn't train the right arm. So you're still gonna be okay on the non-specialized side. But now your body is pressing in the correct position, which is what it should have been a long time ago. This just allowed you to really speed up that progression, if you will. So that's really about it, guys. The three major benefits discussed in full detail, because I'll often see, oh, just do dumbbell bench because there's more range of motion, therefore better pec gains, and you'll correct imbalances because you gotta stabilize like this. That's not good enough for an explanation, I'm sorry. At least now, you know the reasons. So you can tell a friend or a lift at the gym, hey, this is why the dumbbell bench press is so amazing. So I really hope you enjoyed this segment. Let me know what your experience has been with dumbbell pressing. Did you grow that much more compared to the barbell presses? Let's hear it. I'll talk to you all next time.